What's up, everybody? This is the Cody Porter Sports Show, episode 15. And if you can tell by my guests, Brennan Puryear, Andy Steele, it's another wrestling podcast. Before WrestleMania, the Super Bowl of the wrestling calendar, and this is obviously going out before Friday Night SmackDown, and anything could happen on Friday night that could totally change the landscape of one or more matches. Who knows? But I think we're going to get right into it. There's a lot of matches, a lot of really good wrestling going on. We're not even going to talk. I just now thought about it. We're not even talking about anything about NXT. Just completely didn't remember that or the Hall of Fame.
No, that's fine. We don't worry about that.
Paul Heyman's going to have an incredible speech. And then out of that, I don't remember who else is going in. And then NXT, I think, Trick Williams, Carmelo Hayes is going to be sick. And then Ilya is just going to beat Tony D'Angelo. I don't know any other match besides those two. Okay.
I think Roman's going to cry in his speech for Paul Heyman.
I think Roman's the one inducting him. I saw that.
Yeah.
Would have been, I feel like CM Punk could have done it. And
I think it was supposed
they
to
had be. A couple options of who could have done well, it.
I think then, it was supposed to be He Who Shall Not Be Named number three. But. Let's go night one. I think the matches for each night are confirmed. Apparently, there's still one open slot. I read that today. There's one open slot.
Who's it gonna be?
I don't know what that means. And from what I've read, the two. Well, obviously, you know both main events. From what I read, as of like a week ago, they were planning on Rhea Becky starting night one, Drew Seth starting night two. So let's start with night one. Rhea and Becky. For the Women's World Championship, I was saying for a long time, I think it was going to be Becky to face Rhea. I think in our last video when we were preparing for the Royal Rumble, I think two of us picked – I think I picked Becky Lynch. I think you two picked Bayley.
I think I picked Becky.
Okay.
I picked Bayley.
No, Brennan picked Bayley, and that was correct. And from my opinion so far, the Rhea is just so over. It doesn't matter that she's a heel. And I think internally, WWE may have thought that Becky would still have the babyface heat that she always has. And Rhea is just so over that I think originally the plan was to have Becky win, and I don't think that's going to happen anymore. I think Rhea walks out with the championship. And I think the biggest win of her run since last WrestleMania when she beat Charlotte for it. Because like I said the last time, we never got into it, but I do think Becky Lynch is the women's GOAT at this point in time. And I was expecting her to win. At this point, I don't. I think it's Rhea all the way. I think it's going to be a fantastic match. They're both incredible, and it's going to be a great match, and I think Rhea wins. Brennan, what do you think?
I'm with you, man. I ride or die Becky Lynch all the way. She's done everything that she can do. But, man, I do not want her to win. Like, it's one of those moments where I'm just, like, if I could talk to Triple H or whatever, just like, hey, man, just please don't let this happen. Like, in all love. But, no, you're right. Like, Rhea has become just, in a sense, like the new man, you know, like she's just over the top, just all incredible things. I'm interested to see where it'll go. I think, like you said, it'll be a great match. A lot of, you know, their go-to kickouts or having the crowd pops with that. But I'm excited to see it. Let's give it to Rhea again. Let's just have her retain.
Yeah, I am interested because I think kind of for 6 months, this has been building in the background, and for 3 months it's actually been building as the match. And it's kind of like, okay, where does Rhea go after this? Where do either of them go after this? Regardless of the outcome, it will be interesting. Andy?
So speaking of which, it felt like more, I was more excited for Liv to get a chance at either of them. Honestly, I think they've done a good job of if she goes after either of them, which, by the way, we're going to do a lot of matches. I'm going to try to say this once and not anymore. I think this WrestleMania is really good about most of the matches. You know, there's kind of an obvious winner. There's kind of one everyone's leaning towards, but there's that little doubt in every single one of them. I feel like this build has been incredible. Not all the matches have been incredible, but even the ones that aren't incredible, you can't tell who's going to win, which is, you know, I think great for the show overall. I also think Rhea is going to win. I actually want Rhea to win, but to play devil's advocate a little bit, I mean, Rhea loses, Damian and Finn might lose, Dominic might win, you know, with his new friends. You
yeah, it
know,
could be the implosion of the Judgment Day.
So there's a chance, and you know, there could be a double turn. I mean, at this point, Rhea is so dominant and so obviously, in my eyes, the number one female, at least on Raw, on both shows, but on Raw, she feels like the number one female easily. This is the first, I think, contender that's felt like a contender in a long time between all of her opponents recently. And, you know, what scares me a little bit is if she beats Becky, I mean, Liv, but is there really anyone that's threatening?
Yeah, I kind of forgot about Liv because they teased kind of making it a triple threat right after the Royal Rumble. They pushed Liv heavy, and it was right after We Want Cody, everyone started going, We Want Liv, and then they just took her off TV. I do think Liv is the logical next choice because Rhea injured Liv, and that's why she was out. I just kind of don't I think Liv is an incredibly over and popular face. I don't think it's convincing that she can beat Rhea. I think the only convincing person outside of Becky, I mean, there's a couple. I think Charlotte will always be convincing. Who knows when she returns? Could be this weekend, could be Monday. I don't even know what she's doing. I think Bianca's convincing, but there's not a story there right now. I think down the road, Jade would be convincing. But recently injured, every time she comes out, they build her up, is Raquel Rodriguez.
I did forget about her. I'm not gonna lie.
She got hurt. She was coming back. She came back for it was the Battle Royal to go to the Elimination Chamber. She returned. She won. I think she's someone, if she stays healthy, I don't really care for her on the mic, but she is an incredible force in the ring. And that, because with someone in the women's division, if no offense to Liv, but if she has the title, you think, yeah, anyone can beat her. Yeah. Whereas when it's Rhea, that list shrinks drastically. So, but yeah, I also think they've been on again, off again, teasing the implosion of Judgment Day, and it's going to be so good when it happens. It's going to be so good. Gunther and Sammy for the IC title. Brennan, I'll let you start this one.
Man, I think it's a lot of emotions with this, but you have the whole Gunther's had the title for too long, in a sense. Half the people wanted Gable to win for everything. I don't even know how many people really wanted Sammy. I mean, I know everyone loves Sammy, but like, I don't know how many people really wanted this push for him, I guess, you know? Let's see. Where I want it to go, obviously, I want Sammy to win. For me, at least, I'd love to see, like, give Gunther a break, take him on vacation for a little bit, then have maybe, like, some Sammy versus Gable, might have one of them turn heel, you know? Specifically, probably Gable turn heel, because obviously, it's just the perfect thing for I've been here, and where's my moment? I'm gonna make my moment. So that's where I'm going with this. It's short and sweet.
All right, Andy, I think I know where you're leaning. What do you think?
You know, the ring general, right, is gonna win. He's gonna win because of one reason. They're going to Berlin, all right. And I don't think he will be challenging for the heavyweight title yet. So they want him to be in a match with a belt. And I think he will come in as a champion. I also think they didn't pick Gable because whoever was going to face Gunther was always going to lose. Because initially, the rumors were, and I don't know, rumors, after this week, you know, certain wrestlers tell you don't listen to a bunch of fake reporters. But the rumors were that he was supposed to face, you know, guy we can't talk about right now, big guy, you know, who I'm talking about. But he was supposed to face him. I don't see him beating him either. So it was kind of, I feel like they just shifted to another person who, as much as you kind of hate seeing him lose all the time, he is one of the only people in the company that when he loses, he doesn't lose much. You know, he can lose and lose and lose because that is his story. He loses all the time. He only wins every once in a while. And it's so awesome. Though I wouldn't hate Sammy winning. A lot of people are like against him because it should have been Gable, should have been Gable. I kind of like Rocky II, the movie. Okay. So I'm all for him winning, but I think Gunther is going to win. I love his reign. Also, you know, I don't think we should end all the big reigns in the same nights, you know, and there's other reigns that I think might change hands. So I'm going to stick with a ring general.
Yeah.
Andy said that perfectly, so I think I'm on his side now.
That's right.
Let's go. Yeah.
That was great. That was great.
The Bash of Berlin, I do think I thought it was a little sooner than it is. It's August 31st, which is a long time for him to still hold it, especially because talking about title rights, I don't think Logan Paul loses either, because I think he's going to SummerSlam and dropping the title. Mm-hmm. So you're gonna have both mid-card titles being held for forever. If it was Gable, I would, regardless of how the story was going, I would say Gable wins. And Gunther wins it back at Clash of the Castle, which is in June, which is European. He'll be very popular over there. Mm-hmm. I didn't think about this until you just said it. Brennan, talking about Gable and Sammy. I do think Gunther wins. I kind of think Alpha Academy evens the odds with Kaiser and Vinci. They haven't really been around as much in the last couple weeks, I feel like. They're going to be involved. I think you can have Imperium clash with Alpha Academy, but maybe it's Otis and Tozawa that come and they take them out. Gable comes. He's coaching Sammy ringside. And what if Gable costs Sammy the IC title? Gunther wins. He walks out. Sammy and Gable talk in the ring. Gable hits him with a low blow. And then you got a marquee story for both those guys that don't need – neither of them need a title. You don't need a title for that at all.
Because
that is just going to be an incredible story and incredible matches. So, yeah,
Now you said that, dude, I didn't even think about what if Gable throws in the towel?
Oh.
I mean, that might not work happen at all. But, I mean, Rocky, you know, we're kind of like just, this is Rocky. We're in Philly. They're clearly doing a Rocky thing.
That would definitely piss off the fans because it wouldn't be a finish. But that would set up a story for Sammy and Chad where maybe Sammy becomes the heel because Chad is so over and Chad was just looking out for him.
Yeah. Because also, I think if he throws in the towel, Sammy's getting – no cussing. The poop.
Yeah. Correct. Like, it is Chop City.
That'd be kind of fun.
But it's kind of where Sammy's the guy that can just kind of kick out of anything no matter what. Power bomb, clothesline. And it's just like how kicking out of the 1D or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
So we're all on. I left my notes to look up the dates of those pay per views. I did not realize that the Bash of Berlin was August. That is so long. For Gunther to hold the title. He's held it for already, what, 600 days?
400? Four more months.
So long.
Four more
Triple
months.
H likes lengthy title runs, it appears.
He likes beating the old people, like taking their title reigns away or something. I don't know.
All right, next on the list, I got the six-pack ladder match. I don't actually have everyone pulled up in front of me. So, Andy, I'll let you go ahead and start, and I'll pull up all the names, and I'll read them off in a second.
Are we doing two winners? Are we all under the camp that we think they're going to split the belts at this?
I didn't think so until, and I didn't even watch it, but I just saw that Michael Cole was stressing the entire time on last Monday that it will be when a title was grabbed, that title is off the table, but both titles have to be grabbed for the match to be over. So there's no point in them teasing that just to piss people off.
Yeah. Exactly.
So I'm in the camp that it will be split because it needed to be split for a very long time. So yes, I'm under that impression. I don't know about Brendan.
I feel like, I mean, it's going to be 50-50, but I think they'll either give both the titles to someone else, or, you know, they'll give that little moment where a team, one of the tag teams gets one of the belts and then they get thrown off the ladder or whatever. I don't know. I think, and I mean, that's going to be more interesting as well, but yeah.
All right. We got Finn and Damian versus Johnny Gargano and Tommaso Ciampa, The Miz and R-Truth, Kofi and Xavier Woods, Austin Theory and Grayson Waller, Pete Dunne and Tyler Bate, and apparently, allegedly, one of these spots, and it's been rumored for a while that it's Austin Theory and Grayson Waller spot, might be swapped out for somebody. I really hope it's not the Hardy Boys for the,
oh, yeah, no, you make it,
the
make it,
sake make it. Of their lives. I hope it's not the Hardy Boys. I've seen a couple ones. There's one, Motor City Machine Guns, I think, is a tag team. They're rumored. Who knows? Who knows what could happen? I don't know. But those are the teams. Andy, how do you see this six-pack? This is going to be carnage. This is going to be a fantastic match. It's going to be so much fun for casuals to watch this match.
I might have gone too much. I this is one of my favorite matches looking forward to because in my mind, I fantasy booked the crap out of it. Because not only in my mind, what if all four belts are up there and say, this isn't just my thinking, right? I don't think it's going to happen, but I would love this. R-Truth grabs a red one. Damien grabs a red one. I don't know. Who else? Let's say Finn grabs a blue one. And I would rather have it be Johnny Gargano and Austin Theory grab the red ones. And they pull them at the same time and they all come down with a different color belt. And then they have their champion with the person they pull down.
No, I love this. I love this.
I can't say it's completely my idea. I've heard this from other people, but as soon as I heard it, I was like, there's so many different combinations you could do.
See, like, I think that's too goofy, even for WWE.
But like,
no, I think that's perfect goofiness for truth, though.
For truth, yes. Everyone else.
Yeah.
That's the entire tag team division that's in that match, pretty much.
Fair. No. But like, there's also so many histories between all the intermingled, like even Tommaso Ciampa and The Miz, or Finn Balor and like Pete Dunne and Tyler Bate. Like they both, you know, I know they trained together over in the UK a little bit. I mean, there's stuff there. Okay, I've gotten really excited about the match. It's going to be Miz and R-Truth. They're going to win. R-Truth is going to pull down one and go start celebrating. Yeah, I did it. And just forget about the other one. They're all going to go, oh, wait, it's still going on. And someone's going to run up there and get it. Who I think, I hope, is Pete Dunne and Tyler Bate, which are called, what is their name?
New Catch Republic. Yeah. One of the worst tag team names I've ever heard.
British Strong Fouls. Way better. Yeah. And then I think Austin Theory and Grayson Waller are a town down under.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So also that name is way better. I love it.
I don't think so.
I think it's better because it combines their characters. New Catch Republic stinks. That's a terrible name. How do you see this ladder match playing out?
Man, I think I'm with Andy. I hope the awesome truth wins. Kind of hope either like they win both or with Tyler Bates and Pete Dunne. But I just know for a fact that I feel like this, whatever happens at the end of this match will be the start of the end of the Judgment Day with at least Damian and Finn. Or this will bring up their like whole feud of who's the better one. I don't know. I know it's going to be great regardless. I mean, for any WrestleMania with the ladder match, someone is going to get hurt immensely. And everyone is there for it. So someone's got to do a backflip with a ladder in their hand. So it's going to be great.
It is. Because, I mean, usually Money in the Bank, you got six guys. You have 12 people.
It's so much. There's so much that's going to happen.
Much meat.
There is just going to be, like, are all 12 going to start in the ring? Or, like, it is great. That is so many people with ladders.
They're like, do you think they're going to be, like, timing it or whatever?
No, I think they'll probably be, like, two or three, like, with the entrances. Like, probably two or three teams, maybe, like, on the corners. And then two in. And then the last one, maybe they'll run down and they'll just start brawling or something. Because that's so many people. And so, just adding the ladders, just, it's... I hope the ringside area is large.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That.
Or, like, just everyone in the back that's, like... working with the camera crew and everything, they're just like going crazy. Like, we got to get this shot and this shot and this shot. Get along.
Yeah, the camera will have no room to work at all.
Like, go back.
Imagine all the ladder match shots you've ever seen with six or seven people, and then just add six more. Like, the spot where they're like all on ladders across, mm-hmm. just add double six it. More people.
Yeah, exactly. It's crazy.
And you have like everyone, like whoever wins, everyone's going to be celebrating, and then you just. Like those after the air videos where people just show like all of them just walking down. They have to act like they're all hurt and stuff.
Just in a line.
It's gonna be great.
We'll see with the ladder match. Something will be a lot of pain, I do assume. I think the crazy spot, if Austin Theory and Grayson Waller are in the match, they're gonna be a part of a nasty spot. But in the match overall, I think the Awesome Truth wins. I think Miz and R-Truth get a belt, and I think because it's Triple H in charge and he's been pushing them so hard, I think Gargano and Ciampa also get a belt. He loved them. He's always loved them since they were NXT. I don't remember the last time they lost as a tag team. They beat the Creed brothers who were getting pushed unbelievably whenever they got promoted. So I think those two teams win it. I think it starts the slow demise of the Judgment Day. I don't think it'll be rushed. I also think that you could also see JD getting involved because he's not anywhere on any of the cards. And Dom, maybe, but he's also on the card. So depending on when this match is, if he already goes out, less likely for him to come back. But I do assume JD will get involved. Maybe Big E finally comes back, helps Kofi and Xavier Woods win. Who knows? I don't think there's anyone else that would interfere. And then also, there's a chance rumors for a mystery team to take somebody's slot.
Do you have any other teams that you?
Those were the two I seen. It wouldn't make sense for any NXT teams to take. Braun and Baron.
We just synced. We just synced right there.
I would be so. Also, because Braun has been on SmackDown a little bit in the last couple weeks, and he plays like this serious, badass prospect character, but their tag team in NXT is just kind of like goofy. Like their heels are also kind of goofy. I assume they're defending them this weekend on Friday and Saturday. If they're defending them on Saturday and this match is on Saturday, probably unless I don't know who they're facing, so that would help. If I knew who they were facing on Saturday, if they drop the belts and then they say, oh, we're so pissed off, we're going to go attack New Day. New Day doesn't need it. Think of New Day's doing their entrance, and they just come out with chairs and just light them up in the back, throw them over the side, and then just charge the ring. I would be all for Baron Corbin and Bron Baker coming up and immediately grabbing, going from NXT to a WWE Tag Team Championship. Because I am so ready. Baron has been in NXT for so long and done so good. I hated most of his run in WWE at first, but he has just done so good at NXT, and the stuff with Braun has been so good that I don't know why I didn't think of it until the moment Andy said that and I thought of NXT. I thought, why would anyone from NXT come up? And then that team does make sense.
Watching you both in sync was pretty nice right there. That was really good.
We got the six-woman tag team match. Bianca, Naomi, Jay Cargill in her first real match. I guess she was in the Royal Rumble. Versus Damage Control. I think this will be – I don't think this will be a very long match. I think it will be one of the few that I think is under 20. That will be – I don't know what the count is. That one will be under 20, I think. I think it will be mostly Bianca and Naomi with the damage control, and I think there'll be a hot tag to Jade, and she will just – when she came in last week, she is so much bigger than – I know she was huge, and she's not – like, the size difference isn't as noticeable when she was next to Bianca – or, yeah, Bianca. She is so much bigger than everyone in damage control, and she is so jacked. She's going to come in and kill all three of them in about a minute, pin one, and she is on her way to becoming a superstar. That is how I think this one goes. Andy, how about you?
First of all, it's interesting to see who's going to take the pin. I think we all are going to pick the same people here. I'm sorry, Brennan. I hate to spoil your pick, but I think we're all picking the same person here. And the thing for me is that I hope that she just picks two of them up and throws them. I don't even know where they're going, but I just because like she, first of all, you know, she's green. This is a perfect match for her. She's working with some maybe the best women's wrestlers in general. I shouldn't even, but some of the best wrestlers wow. in the company. You know, Bianca Belair can wrestle. By the way, I just want. I think.
Yeah, she's great. I still hate her gimmick. I hate the hair thing. I hate that
she went to the University of Tennessee. You take that back right now.
Yeah, I hate that too. So,
but so it's gonna be perfect for her. I agree completely with you. I think she'll get a hot tag. I think she'll come in. She'll pick up people who probably is a warm up for her in her workouts, and she will throw them in directions that we've hopefully never seen. The way she picked up Nia Jax, I don't think there's anyone on the roster she can't pick up with ease. Like she picked up Nia Jax like it was me picking up my daughter.
When she picked up Kairi Sane, it looked like she was picking up a baby. Like no. legit. Kairi Sane was being held up.
If she gets good at wrestling, which I'm not going to say that she's really good right now. If she gets, you know, technically good, I mean, sky's limits for her.
And she could be better than what we know at this point. I mean, she's been signed with the WWE for, what, 4 or 5 months now? She could be a lot better than most people think. So, I think, based on what you said, I think Dakota Kai takes the pin because I don't think you let the champs take it. Also, they haven't had a tag team title match that was really relevant, I feel like, in a while. Women's tag team division. I want the print. The Iconics need to come back. They are such a good deal.
I feel like everybody wants them to come back because they're like the only tag team that felt like just a tag team.
Every other tag team, like Asuka and Kairi is one, but it's kind of just like every other tag team is like, let's just take two really good heels or two really good faces and let's put them together and they'll hold the titles for 4 months. Brennan, do you seem to agree with our sentiments here on this one?
Oh, yeah, no, I don't have much more to add to that. That's going to be Bianca, Naomi, Jade, going to be the winners. Hot tag. I do like that she's got Naomi and Bianca with her just to feel like I'm guessing to feel more comfortable with everything. And we'll see how it goes. I'm interested to see how it goes. No, they're going to destroy damage control. Like one move, what you talk about, they're going to throw them off the ring and we're all actually going to be like, oh, they might be actually hurt right now.
Yeah, I think the size difference is so large. Like Jade could do something crazy. Like, she could deliver a clothesline from hell that, like, double spins them out. Like, something insane.
Oh, my God. Don't give her ideas.
Moving on.
She's going to hear
that. Watching this right now.
Moving on, and I'm going to bring this up with this. I feel like there aren't a whole lot of stipulations on the card in general. It's a lot of just straight-up regular, obviously, numerous people and so on. But, like, you have the ladder match, you have the street fight with the Final Testament, Lashley and the Prophets, and then you have night two, which I think will be tribal combat. And then other than that, it's all just regular matches. I really thought for the longest time, and I heard this and I thought, oh, this is a fantastic idea. I thought that Jimmy and Jay would be the City of Brotherly Love street fight because it makes perfect sense.
Ooh, yeah.
And it's a regular match. I assume Solo will be heavily involved. Brennan, you can start this one off. How do you think this one goes?
Man, I'm kind of excited for it. Just the whole brother v brother kind of thing. They're both going to be wanting to make the other one look good. They're already going to be in sync from everything. I just hope it's not too slow. I know they like to take their time a little bit, but it should be great. What I'm more excited for is kind of like the aftermath. First of all, I'm going to say Jay's going to win. I feel like he has to. Yeah. And what was it? Loved. What was it? Rikishi just being happy. That was a good little proud moment for him. I like that. I can see it in the future. This will, after this match, the fall of the bloodline, give it a couple months, maybe a month or two, they're going to be a tag team again, I think. Maybe. Or not. I don't know. They'll build that dynamic with the no yeet, yeet thing. I don't know. That's what I got.
Andy, how do you see this one doing?
This one I'm the least confident in. Because Brendan, everything Brendan said, you know, makes sense. Yeet. He's, I think, the number one selling t-shirt right now is Jay's stuff. Like, he is making the company a lot of money. But I'm looking at the night as a whole, and I think Bloodline's going to run. I guess I keep spoiling everyone's picks. I'm sorry. But I think Jimmy's – also, Jay doesn't need it as much. Jimmy kind of needs it more. Jimmy doesn't feel like a solo player right now. Jay feels like he could face anyone. Also, I'm kind of a little disappointed with the build.
Jay had Gunther beat.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Jay had Gunther beat.
Yeah.
Until Jimmy screwed him over.
I'm a little bit disappointed with the build because it feels like they could have done more with it. Like you said, Brotherly Love Street Fight should have been them. But I understand why they gave it to the other match, because the other match nobody would want to watch it if it didn't have that stipulation. So I kind of understand that. I think Jimmy wins though. I least confident. If I were to rank 1 out of 14 confidence level of all the matches, this is my 14th most confident. Like, I think Jay, a part of me thinks Jay will win, but I think they might go all Bloodline tonight.
Yeah. So. I think this match also has a lot to do with later on in the evening. Because, you know, what if both men are so incapacitated that they aren't available to help either side at the end of the night? I ultimately think that little brother Solo is heavily involved, and that's why Jimmy wins.
Oh, let's go. I thought I'd be alone on this one.
I mean, I want Jay to win, obviously, but I mean, I think the amount of people that will be involved in the main events is going to be crazy. And I think you have Solo keep Jimmy alive. Jimmy wins the match. They stomp out Jay. Jay's not available to help the rest of the weekend. And I'm also disappointed. I think they could have had a segment every single week with these guys, and they've had like three. Mm-hmm. It's been underwhelming, and you know from what they did with Sammy when he was a part of the Bloodline, and when they split, they are so good. They are legit on the mic. And I mean, not to go way back down the road, Jimmy's turn on Jay still makes zero sense. It makes no sense. They never explained it well. Whatever.
I mean,
no.
Kind of see it, but you definitely have to think about it, and you kind of have to build it for them.
You have to heavily agree that they're just crazy, I think.
But like right before Jimmy like destroyed his match or whatever with Roman, with him and Roman and Jay, like they were on the same team.
They were in the exact same team. Jimmy is the reason Jay ended up being the most loyal to Roman after Sammy left. Jimmy is the first one that super kicked him. Mm-hmm. God dang it. Like, I don't know why my Zoom just goes sideways. Jimmy is the first one that super kicked them. It doesn't make sense. Whatever. You had to have Roman win, I guess, because Cody.
Jimmy did all that just for Jay to get all the glory, just for Jay to get all the championship matches.
And then he said, I didn't want to see you turn into Roman. But that doesn't make any sense. Whatever. Doesn't matter. I think Jimmy wins. Due to Solo interference. Also, I think Solo is so bland. I don't.
The fact every that. He, time, like, whenever he comes out and like there's like a whole someone's messing with the ref or with someone in the ring, it's my favorite least favorite thing when they're like, oh, who is it under the hood? It's Solo again. Here we go. And he just has
Also,
the same bland face every time. I'm like, yeah, I did this. Yeah, this is overplayed. Anyway, sorry. That's a rant.
the fact that he beat John Cena, and I also think that John Cena just refuses to win anymore whenever he does come out.
I'm just building other people.
Cena could have beat him. It could have been the last one of the last like hurrah, I'm still John Cena moments. But instead they give it to Solo, and Solo has not won a match since then. 0-34 since Cena. So really, also Cena's trying to put these guys over. Last two guys he's beat, they lost everything afterwards. When he beat Austin Theory, he had nothing for so long. A time down under, kind of over, not kind of, I think it's kind of over, whatever. Solo has not done anything. No one cares about Solo. He's just a menace, whatever. I hate the whole bloodline. We got the last match on this list. Obviously, you don't know the whole order. Rey and Dragon Lee versus Santos and Dominic. I really thought it was going to be Carlito. Dragon Lee was kind of random, but also Dragon Lee can carry the match on their side. He's so freaking good. Carlito still hasn't really done a whole lot when he has had matches. Kind of just hits a DDT, hits a backstabber, hits a suplex, and about it.
I mean, he's just there for the fans, which is totally understandable.
And I assume that we will have all of LWO. I kind of thought at one point we were going to build to a massive, and this could be a Survivor Series down the line, especially if Dominic goes over. You could have all of Legado del Fantasma, whatever the hell it's called, plus Dom, plus Andrade. And now you have this LWO with Carlito, with Rey, with Dragon Lee. It could be a crazy, like, 5-on-5, whatever match. But this one, I'll be honest, I'm not. They added Dom last week. I think we always have been wanting Santos and Rey, and they just did it on SmackDown, and then Dom had the interference. So I think, I mean, Santos and Dragon Lee are the best two workers of the four. I think they'll have some incredible stuff. Dom is good. Rey is great. I think the bad guys get the win. I think Dom and Santos win. And now in the series overall, it's Rey Dom 1-1. I think there'll be a third one. I don't know if they're doing it every WrestleMania. That would be kind of cool, but also a long time. Rey's getting up there.
Stem cells, baby.
Yeah,
They
but
live forever.
yeah, I think Dom pins Rey. I think that's how the I think Rey takes the pin. I don't think Dragon Lee takes the pin.
I see that. I can see that.
I think Rey takes it from I was gonna say confidently Dom pins Rey. I think one of them pins Rey, because Santos also has a story that's less a little cared about. But also, Dom getting the pin will just get him even more heat. Because it's awesome. Brennan, what do you think of this one?
No, I'm agreeing 100%. I think it's going to be a great match to watch, though. Like you said, with Santos and Dragon Lee, it's just going to be anytime a match like that, especially with Rey, it's going to be they'll pull some great stuff out that you haven't seen in a while or you've never seen before. It's going to be good.
Andy.
You said Survivor Series, and they got me, thinking for a little bit, because in my mind, I thought the heels are gonna win. I'm gonna add this little wrinkle. If I was Carlito, I'd be pretty mad that I was left out, Like Ray's like, I need a partner, I need a partner. Carlito's like, it's me, it's me. And he goes, Dragon Lee. And he goes, wait.
He wasn't
First
even
of
in the
all,
LWO. He had three people to pick from.
that's
You
true.
pick anyone.
Even in the highlight, just like see them cheering for Carlito when they were about to announce Dragon Lee, and you're just like, oh, come on, sorry.
But also, Carlito's better as a heel. So,
Oh.
it's time for some apple biting, some spitting in the face of people who don't want to be cool. I think it's time. I mean, he came back at us like, oh, we're happy you're back. You're happy. We're all happy. We're all happy. Time to be a heel again. Betray Ray. Help Dom, because I love that Dom never wins clean. If Dom wins, it's never clean. And that's just a part of him that I want to always be a part of him. Even if he becomes a good guy, I just never want him to win clean. Just always something happens. So I feel like we're all picking the same people. It'd be interesting to see if there's a turn or if they just straight up beat him. Because, like you guys said, I'll say it a third time because it's worth saying it a third time. Dragon Lee, Phantos, super workers. I'm so excited for this match. Mainly because it's the match from last year, Rey and Dom. Great match on its own. Just added a bunch of super workers. Mm-hmm. Good. It's going to be even better. So.
Oh, yeah.
The only thing, the only comment I have on that, on the Carlito heel turn is that Way sways the numbers towards the heels.
Yeah.
Unless, I do think Dom teams with Rey one more time before Rey retires. Maybe not a championship or whatever. I do think Dom goes face before Rey retires. But I think it's going to take a long time. It's going to be a very, very long process. Kind of like the process was of him turning heel. I think it will like I don't think Dom could possibly be a face by Survivor Series. I don't think the crowd can
change. They're not ready. Give it like another year.
They love hating him so much.
Yeah.
Like it will take so long and so many months of building. But yeah, I mean, if you don't add an Andrade, kind of just adding Andrade, that's all Latino. But apparently one of those, I don't know either of the two, the tag team at LWA, I don't know either of those guys. Apparently one of them is not Hispanic or something. I don't know. Dom made that comment the other night. I thought that was really funny.
That was a really good one.
That was good. But yeah, it'll be just a fantastic match. Main event, night number one, Rock and Roman, Seth and Cody, Andy, I'll let you start this one off.
I think I, gave away my pick a little earlier. What interests me, because I think it has to be Bloodline Rules on Sunday. Though there is a part of it that if it's a regular match, it's just one-on-one, and there's a beauty to that a little bit, but I think it has to be Bloodline Rules. What interests me is who's gonna take the pin. And I think the only pin, because again, if we're saying either side could win, the only pin I don't see happening is Roman on Seth, because Seth's whole thing is Roman's never hasn't pinned him. Like I don't think that's gonna happen. But I could literally see any of the other three combinations or the other, like I think anyone could pin Cody. I mean, that would show that he's, can he do it? He's, had a tough night the night before or whatever. Seth could be pinned because it goes into a storyline of, he's getting beat up and now he has to go face Drew. Same thing. If the good guys win, Rock could take a pin from either of them, though I don't see that. And I don't think Roman takes a pin. So in my mind, it interests me more who's going to take the pin, but I think the bad guys win through shenanigans.
Yeah. See, I think Rock and Roman win. I think Solo is involved. I think if Jimmy wins, I think Jimmy also gets involved. And I think night two is when the tie turns. But I hate Cody taking the pin night one. I do understand how it builds the underdog, but I just hate how if Cody wins night two, it's coming off right off of taking a pin night. I don't know.
But if Rock pins him and then he pins Roman, yeah. Rock can say, well, I pinned him. Why couldn't you pin him?
Yeah. Also, I do think Seth can take the pin from either Roman. It kind of takes the heat off of Cody a little bit. And also it just being a grueling match and Seth already being kind of injured. He's the one that takes the pin. He comes in night two, a little hobbled Drew Rexon. But I don't, whatever. Yeah, it'll be a fantastic match. I think there'll be shenanigans. I think the bad guys win. I think it's going to be a fantastic match. Obviously, it's not really going out on a limb to say that the main event would be the best match of the night, because that's kind of the point. But these two main events are going to be spectacular. I don't know in my head who takes the pin. I think Seth can, but storyline-wise, Cody taking it makes so much more sense. I would love for it to be a fair fight night two. That's just not going to happen. I would love Cody to pin Rock night one, pin Roman night two. The bloodline is dead forever. That would be great. That's not going to happen. And that's also setting up for a amazing night two match that's going to have 57 different things going on. I don't think anyone comes out in favor of Cody and Seth. Potentially Jay, maybe. If Jimmy and Jay don't have like a incredibly grueling match, I could see them coming out and maybe prolonging that feud since they didn't have such an amazing build. That would be one way to do it. But I can't really think of anyone else unless I'm thinking all the help comes night two, not night one. So I think Rock and Roman win. Brennan, how do you see night one, main event one going?
I mean, like y'all said, this is going to be this is one where I'm kind of like, whoever wins this, it's just going to be beautiful because it's going to start the rest of the second night. It's going to start the rest of the year. It's just going to be like, it's all the ingredients for the nice cake we're getting. I think if, what is it? If Cody and Seth win, that's when you start the whole downfall. Rock and Roman win, you got the whole idea of, oh, maybe the bloodline's going to stick this one out. I get it. I get it. I get it.
You're gonna make Cody upset.
I'm not saying it to upset. I'm just saying how it is. But I do agree as well. I think all the returns or help will be for the second night. But this will be one that just plays with your emotions, I think. So get you ready for the next day.
Oh yeah. I think that's well said. One thing I was going to say when you said it, I don't remember. Something I had heard a couple weeks ago or read was that maybe it's Rock pins Cody night one, Cody wins night two, setting up next year Rock and Cody for the title. Cody, well, presumably Cody wins, kind of cementing this second run as him being the superstar of wrestling. So,
yeah.
Because The Rock is shooting a movie. I think it's May to September of this year, something like that.
That's so wild.
He's not going to have like a post WrestleMania run because he is shooting a movie. But apparently, allegedly, that there's obviously anything can be said on wrestling internet, and it will be believed by a lot of people, no matter how crazy it is. If he ends in September, if he comes back around Survivor Series or something, and he maybe doesn't screw over Cody in something, but Cody wins a match over someone, if you smell, place blows up, be great. Be fantastic. Whatever.
I think it'll build more towards, because I think it'll build more towards Roman and Rock before they would do. I don't know when they would do it. Now that you said that filming thing, because I was like, oh yeah, they could do that next WrestleMania at SummerSlam. They could do Roman and Rock. But I think they have to do Roman and Rock before Cody Rock. Because that would be Rock claiming to be the tribal chief at that point, because tribal chief gets to
tribal chief world. Bloodline nonsense will be dead in 6 months.
That's your wish. That's
bloodline
guy is coming through.
Obviously everyone wanted Rock Roman, duh. It would have been fine. It wouldn't be as good. I just mean kind of like in the last few years, not the last 6 months. In the last few years, everyone's been like, okay, Roman's the guy. He's going to have to take down The Rock at some point. That's kind of always been someone's head. And now I think it still holds weight without Roman having the belt, but not the same amount of weight. However, in theory, you could make it a more than a one-off match if Roman doesn't have the belt, because Rock could win one, and then Roman could win two or whatever. But with the belt, you obviously, it's wrestling. I think what we've mentioned before, obviously, The Rock doesn't get the title, but it could happen.
Because
it happened last time he came back.
They thought that last time.
We were talking about a Hall of Fame, and it's on Friday. That's all we got out of it. I don't know. At a point in time, SmackDown for a while was not on Fridays, and it made sense to have the Hall of Fame on Friday. Yeah. It is now on Friday after SmackDown. I'm not going to watch it. So I will watch Paul Heyman's induction the next day. That's it.
Yeah, you just watch the highlights every time. It's fine.
Yeah, and I assume Bray will be the headliner next year. I think that would make the most sense.
Yeah.
I was shocked they didn't do it this year. Maybe it's just out of respect to try to give him
I kind of think it was a
time.
little too soon.
Yeah.
But I do think it'll be next year. All right. Night one is over. It is now night two. It is Sunday. Kicking off, believed to be kicking off, not a guaranteed fact. Drew and Seth with CM Punk on commentary. I think there's a lot of room for some craziness via CM Punk, via Damian Priest. As much as I do, I don't know, do. Damian should probably get a title out of this. I can't really see him getting any momentum if he loses with it. But Drew just deserves to have a run in front of people so badly. And I think it makes sense, Clash of the Castle, for him to win this from Seth. And Seth's had it for so long, he's defended it so much, and he's been hurt, and that's kind of been like the main story of the last two feuds, is that he was just hurt going into it and he still won. I think this is a relatively short match. I think maybe they end up by commentary, they spill it over there, and Punk might throw water in someone's face and get them distracted. Maybe that gets Drew distracted, sets up a near finish with Seth winning, he kicks out, whatever. But I think Drew should dominate this match. I think he should exploit Seth's already injuries, regardless. Plus, coming off of battle night one, I think Drew should win. I think he should show his power. I think he should walk away with the World Heavyweight title. Brennan, what do you?
No, I agree. I think Drew should win. Side note as well, I've loved him as heel. I think it's been so good. Just so much fun. Yeah, I think the big thing, like you said, Seth's gonna be in there not 100% with the injury, and he's already had the match. Basically, the only thing that Drew's gotta worry about is Punk with something. What was it? What I had some notes. I put in my notes just so we can talk about it again, when they were all doing their little promos, and Punk looks at McIntyre and goes, "Who called you the chosen one?" Sorry, that's all. That's all I gotta say.
That was good. I was so when he said that, I was like, I kind of got queasy. I'm like, this is not the Triple H didn't know they were gonna say this. This is
No,
crazy.
Triple H was in the background, either with straight face or he was like little laugh, exhale through the nose. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I think the exhale came whenever they steered away from
Oh yeah.
it.
But yeah, no, I think Drew's got this. I can see Damian Priest calling it in, calling his briefcase in, but I don't I could see them also like that's it. He's gonna lose it and now it's not gonna happen. I don't know. But Drew's gonna win. Let's see where that goes.
I'm thinking now, just based on what I said, Clash of the Castle, you do want to give Drew his moment. Maybe he wins, Priest cashes in, wins it, then that has that feud. Drew wins it in front of his home at Clash of the Castle, more as a face.
Yeah.
Or just gets involved. Maybe Damian doesn't. Maybe Priest, or maybe Punk does interfere, roll up, McIntyre loses. Destroys Seth post-match, cash in. Seth is now out. He can take his time off. And then that sets up Damian Drew for Clash of the Castle. Who knows? There's a couple of different ways. However, what I would like to see happen
Yeah, no,
is
I
just
got
Drew.
you.
Andy?
You kind of said everything I was going to say. I think I agree with both of y'all. I will say, I think Drew McIntyre has been one of my favorite wrestlers this past few months. I've always thought that, on the mic, that was his weakest thing, and now it just feels like he can talk with anyone. But the thing that happened with Punk, I don't know if it was, they probably talked about it beforehand, especially hearing his interview with on the MMA Hour later. I don't think he went off script. That'd be crazy if he did. I think they probably talked about it. But even so, it seemed like, this person, CM Punk, that we see as a great talker on the mic. Drew was punching right back at him with every line. It just felt like he just, it was, it, that was probably one of my favorite segments of the year. Everyone killed that segment. And it made me so excited. It makes me sad that Punk is hurt, because imagine this triple threat. Or imagine if CM Punk had the belt and or Drew had the belt and they're facing each other. They don't even need
Well, it's
Seth.
just the down the road, the CM Punk Drew feud and the CM Punk Seth feud is going to, I think it ends up being Punk and Rollins at next year's Mania. And that's just going to be so, so good.
Really? This,
oh, they're not going to hold back on the mic or in the ring. It's going to be great.
I do think, I don't think I said I want Drew to win. I can see Seth winning for two reasons. A lot of reasons I could see Seth winning. But I want to see Drew come into his home with the belt. I want to see that entrance. I want to see him walk in, like, with the belt raised high. Like, even if he loses the match, I want to see him come in with it. I feel like that would be worth it a lot more than even him winning it there. So.
And he'll let you keep going. U.S. title match. KO, Randy, your boy Logan Paul, triple threat. Well, I guess now that I was thinking earlier, how's not any stipulations? Triple threat does mean no disqualification. So there's that, I guess. Andy, what do you see playing out?
Unfortunately, but also I get why they have to announce it. Because they announced SummerSlam in Cleveland and it was Logan who announced it, and also with Jake having his fight with Tyson, I think they're going to want Logan to walk out with the belt on his shoulder. And I think that Kevin Owens is in this match just to take the pin so that they can have a big match at SummerSlam with Randy and Logan, or Randy doesn't have to take the pin after just coming back. Kevin can kind of take the pin. It's fine. He made him into 2 WrestleManias in a row. He can take a pin. But I do think, not unfortunately either, I think Logan is getting better and better, as weirdly as that sounds, because he was good to begin with, but I think he's getting better and better each week. Maybe not the greatest human on the planet, but he's got a knack for this thing, and it's very enjoyable to watch. So I think Logan wins.
Brennan?
I'm pulling for Randy, as always. I think, if I'm right, if he wins this, he'd be the all-time champion. Is that right?
I think of real championships in total, not of world championships, but
yeah.
Because R-Truth, I think, is the most decorated superstar of all time.
Because of the
24/7 championship runs.
I feel like Logan's gonna win. I think Andy's right about that. They're gonna take him with that, but I would like to see Randy win. But I do want more. If this builds from like another feud, maybe Randy versus Owens, maybe that'd be nice. I don't know what's gonna happen. This one, I want Randy to win, but I feel like I'm gonna be let down.
I mean, Randy doesn't need the belt at this stage.
Yeah.
The U.S. belt. I think Logan Paul wins, and I think I probably saw the same thing as Andy, unless Andy came up with his own, which is possible, of Logan walking out with Jake for the Mike Tyson fight with the U.S. title draped around him. It will look so good for WWE. There's going to be so many eyes on that. I think he wins. Only gripe I have with Logan, and I have the same one with Roman, but it's a little different because he isn't a wrestler. He's a personality that became a wrestler, is that he's not around enough. But I also know he signed a contract, which I think he means he'll start being, and he's been around recently. But also you can think that's because of WrestleMania and him being kind of forced to, but regardless, I do think he carries it to SummerSlam and has a great match. He already kind of had a few with KO, and I don't know if that continues or if maybe if this goes to a Randy KO feud, that'll be great. That'll be fantastic. I don't know. I don't know who Logan goes on after this. Honestly, I'm not sure. You think is what? SummerSlam's in August or July? Probably the 1st of August. It's a while. And I don't really know. I don't know who. I don't know who he'll. I don't know if it's that's a long time to go without any feuds. And I don't know if he will, but that would suck to have that title off TV for that long. But I do think Logan Paul is. Andy, are you seeing some interesting information on your screen?
Oh yeah, sorry. Edge has a lot more championships than everybody
else. Not than R-Truth.
Oh yeah. I'm not counting R-Truth.
R-Truth is the most decorated superstar of all time. Oh, Reginald. This is off camera. Reginald was the name of Scripps.
Yeah.
Was The backflip dude.
Backflip guy,
Different
yeah.
conversation. Shout out Scripps.
Shout out Scripps.
Moving on to a match I don't care about whatsoever.
It's a filler match.
Lashley and the Profits versus the Final Testament. I think they've tried really hard to kind of build this. I think Triple H loves Karrion Kross, but nothing he ever does. It resonated in NXT. Nothing he does on the main roster gets over. From what I see, just nothing ever works. AOP is always dominating with their runs, but they're kind of bland. They don't really have any character, any substance, other than Paul Ellering being their manager. So I guess Lashley and the Profits win, unless they have more in store for the Final Testament. Although I could see Triple H giving up and saying we tried and it didn't work. But that's mine. Brennan, what about you?
No, that's 100%. It's just for me, I mean, for everyone, it's just a filler match. And I'm going to pick the Final Testament because I'm also a Karrion Kross fan. Man does a great Jesse Ventura impression, if you ever heard it.
Are you a great Karrion Kross fan, or are you a big Scarlett fan?
Off the record, we'll talk about that. I'm both, you know. Anyways, Andy.
I actually thought, okay, so I also am going for Karrion Kross. I don't know if you guys have seen this. It's so unfortunate. It's so unfortunate. The best promos I've ever seen him ever cut is on their YouTube. I have no idea why they're not putting it on TV. They're cutting like these exclusive, you know, the backstage stuff that they do every SmackDown or Raw, you know. And he's giving these great promos, and I watch the video. I'm like, man, like this makes me like very interested in him. And I think, why is he not doing this on TV at all? Like it's really frustrating. I do think they need to win a lot more. Bobby Lashley is this weird character in WWE that he can't
be a heel.
He literally feels like he can never lose because he's booked strong all the time, but yet he's not like in the title picture. But you feel like he's gonna win like every match he's in. But this also feels like it was on WrestleMania because Bobby Lashley was not on it last year. He got snubbed last year, and I think they couldn't do that 2 years in a row. And so, not that everybody else in the match should, you know, are not worthy of a WrestleMania match, but they should be thankful. I think that's the reason why they're on here. Though the street fight stipulation makes this where it will be fun,
mm-hmm.
hopefully. Like, I think it will be carnage. Bunch of meat in there, just meeting it up, you know, hitting each other with stuff. Like, it's gonna be good. It's just, it's gonna be fun. You're not gonna care who wins, but you'll enjoy the journey, hopefully.
Yeah, there's just not enough technicality with AOP to where a regular tag match would have done it good. But with it being a street fight, they're gonna throw the other guys through some tables. Ford's gonna jump off a 40-foot ladder, and it's gonna be insane. So it'll be a fun match, but storyline wise, I don't think anyone cares. Bobby needs a title soon, I think. It's just he always wins, but it's just kind of what's the point at this juncture?
Him versus Logan would be so good, by the way.
Who?
Him and Logan.
Yeah, I would love to see him just tear him in half. It would be hilarious. Also, they kind of tease the Ford heel turn on Dawkins for a while, and then they just joined Bobby Lashley as heels, and then no one took them as heels because no one will ever take Bobby Lashley as a heel.
Ever. The beginning was so good too. I love that they changed their attitudes. They're wearing suits now. I was like,
they were suits.
The Street Profits again.
They beat up the LWO, and now they're just the same thing. They're just the Street Profits again. It's just because they were the Hurt Profits when they were, and now it is listed, I think, as Bobby Lashley and the Street Profits.
Sounds like a band.
But also the Street Profits are such a good tag team. I am fine, and I would like them to never break up. Just let them have multiple tag team runs and do crazy matches because they're great at it.
Mm-hmm. I don't
know. That's just my opinion. But a match that I think, if it weren't for The Rock existing, would be a strong candidate to be a main event on one of these nights. Io Sky and Bayley for the WWE Women's Championship. Brennan called Bayley at the Royal Rumble. So, Brennan, I'll let you take over this first. How does this story go?
I feel like Bayley's got it. I'll just do a short and sweet. Bayley's got it. I think the damage control, they're going to kind of try to interfere, but they're also going to be, from the day before, they're going to be hurt. They're going to be hurt. I'm interested still. I've liked how they've built it up. I think I've liked Io Sky and how they've kind of built her up. I like her as a heel. I'm interested where they'll take it, but for that night, Bayley's got it.
Yeah, I think there's a chance they play on that maybe Damage Control doesn't come out because of how badly they were brutalized by Jade Cargill.
Yeah,
I think Bayley wins. I think the kind of when she won the Royal Rumble, everyone knew it was gonna be her and Io. And Io's run has kind of just been blah. It hasn't been a whole lot. Mm-hmm. It was nice to see her win it, but I guess I don't know. Her run's kind of been lackluster, but it set up for this great story for Bayley. And I think the oh holy crap moment was when Bayley spoke Japanese.
Yeah.
That was just, I literally, like, the hair on my arm stood up watching that the first time. Like, oh, hold, that's crazy. That is so cool.
And you just hear the crowd go, oh, my God.
Yeah. Just, and the EO's face just was shocked. It's so good. I think Bayley wins. I don't know where it goes afterwards at all. But, Andy, anything different? Any differing opinions?
I have actually quite a bit right now. I Dang. Don't like the way they built this up, mainly because it feels like it was forgotten for a little bit there. I feel like I felt like one of those matches that I thought when she won the Rumble and turned, that was a great turn on them to go after, you know, turn on Damage Control and all that stuff. The problem for me is I thought it was going to get to the point of her being a babyface, but she's just turned, she's not done any babyface stuff. She just, you know, she realized these people weren't like her friends. Like last week or last Friday when she was talking to Bianca, and Bianca's like, just because you turn on them doesn't mean we're friends. Why would we be friends? Like, it perfectly encapsulates that. I thought they were going to get to the point that at WrestleMania she was going to come out to her old theme. But it feels like it doesn't even deserve that. It just feels like she needs to win. I feel bad. The whole thing just feels forgotten because Io had a terrible reign, and I think it's just going to end without some big. And there's so much other going on in WWE, so I get why they couldn't build it up as much. But I was looking forward to this build a lot. I think that's my maybe one. I've always been like a Bayley guy. I've always liked Bayley, and I looked forward to it too much, but I'm actually kind of disappointed in it.
You're a big
and hugger. I think she'll win. Wait, what'd you say?
So you're a big hugger.
Oh yeah, I'm a big hugger. I do love hugging. But I think not only will Bayley win, and it'll be kind of underwhelming a little bit. I think people will still love her. People will love Bayley anyway. I think she's gonna lose it like very soon after. Like, I don't think she'll have it for a long time. I think this is her getting it. It's supposed to be a big blow up, and then I think she loses it pretty quick.
All right, can you fantasy book it? Who does it?
It depends. Like I said, they're not making her like a really big baby face. But there's possibilities, you know. From the women's match, the tag team, one of those three come after her and beat her. It's a possibility Io wins it back. Like, it's
they haven't done that. So underwhelming. Obviously, there's been a lot of long title reigns. One of the only things I don't love about Triple H's control is that I do think short title reigns are fine and good and serve a purpose. I mean, they're. John Cena has 15 world title reigns. I think like 9 of them are less than 100 days. And he's the GOAT, in my opinion.
Right.
It's not maybe not nine. It's a lot. I did see, like, I read this the other day. That he has a lot of title reigns that are less than 100 days.
Yeah.
And so it's kind of like, yeah, they can be good. I don't think, I think Io has done nothing really in her title reign to make it so she'd win it. I could see whoever gets the Money in the Bank winning it, but that's for another 2 months, 3 months, which at this point in time isn't a long reign. So that's fine.
That's what I meant also. I don't mean like she'll lose it the next SmackDown. Like, I think she might have one defense.
All fantasy book this. Rhea's on Monday night, right? Her title is on Monday night. Raw after Mania. Bayley comes out, open challenge. Who does Triple H bring out? But what's her face? The chick who got fired for posting inappropriate pictures with
Mandy Rose.
Mandy Rose. Because Triple H loves Mandy Rose. There was rumors she was coming back at the Rumble. But if she comes back, it wins. That's stupid.
That would be crazy.
There you go. Hopefully something crazy happens on Monday.
Oh, I hope so, because that's really, because I remember last year's just wasn't anything. Last year's just
kind of good. Brock just beat up. I mean, he who should not be named just beat up.
That was an interesting part in that. That was interesting because that set up months for Cody.
But that was the only thing.
There's nothing really cool going on. Yeah. Maybe you can say that's because the champion sucked. But the wrestling show, that would be so much more fun than other sports. Just talking about wrestling is so much more fun, I think.
Dude, yeah. I have less misery. I have a lot less misery watching wrestling than I do.
My entire livelihood of what I enjoy with wrestling will be determined on Sunday night.
Honestly.
We got one more match before the main event. That's staying true. That's going to be part of it. That's how serious I'm taking this match. Not this one. LA Knight, yeah. AJ Styles.
Yeah.
I think LA Knight wins. I don't have any deep thoughts on it or cares, really. I like the AJ Styles really jacked heel character. Although I think it makes sense to have that exact AJ Styles heel character with Gallows and Anderson. But instead, he kind of told them, like, screw off. And while they're kind of staying just, like, the badass faces, I think unless Gallows and Anderson come help AJ Styles, maybe it's a DQ and LA Knight gets the win. But if Gallows and Anderson come out with, like, their face paint and, like, their New Japan gear, and they just come and stomp LA Knight, that would be fine. Other than that, I think, yeah, wins.
I think that's probably most likely. I'm wanting AJ Styles to win. But as a match itself, it's going to be interesting because you're going to have to watch, like, if anything, LA Knight's got to keep up with AJ Styles, which is a fun thing to say, I think. I don't know. I could be wrong. But you know he's going to bring his A game. And LA Knight's, I don't know. We're just going to see. But I want AJ to win. That's all.
Andy?
I feel like there's a lot of hate for this match a little bit because people want an LA Knight for a championship. But to say it's a downgrade to face AJ Styles at WrestleMania is, I don't know how that statement became so popular. I'm very excited to watch the match, though I will say one of my least most excited to watch just because, I mean, I love LA Knight. I love AJ Styles. I don't know who I want to win. I'm going to pick LA Knight right now because I think LA Knight needs it. AJ can lose for the rest of his life and people would still love to watch him. So I'm excited for it. That's all I have to add to. It's just going to be a nice match.
Yeah. I think kind of the way they can do this is just kind of, I mean, LA Knight's already just a big brawler type. He's not a technical guy. AJ with his new size, you can kind of just make this a brawl, and I think that'd be pretty enjoyable. You just have them just going back and forth the entire time, and the crowd will be into it, just going boo yeah as they're trading blows. I think that'll be good. And the kind of thing is just because I feel like everyone pretty unanimous, other than Kevin Nash, just loves LA Knight, but he is older, quote unquote, I feel like the moment his run, whenever he loses some amount of his overness in this run, whether that's in 2 months or 2 years, I think that's kind of the end. I think it's taken him so long to reach this point. He's put in so much, and to where I think he knows it too sometimes. He's fantastic on the mic. Duh. There's sometimes, because part of his arsenal is that his run up, superflex off the top rope, and he kind of always botches it. Like, not every time, but it's always shaky. It always looks scary. And one really bad match botch can end a run. And I think with LA Knight, as unfortunate as it is, that could be more or less the end of his superstardom, which he's on. But he's been put in programs over the last year with stars. He's with AJ Styles, bona fide stud. And love LA Knight. I hope continues. I hope he goes to SummerSlam. Maybe takes that title off of Logan Paul. Who knows? Andy?
I feel for LA Knight because in TNA, he was just as good, I think, he is now as he is now. So it's kind of like, he was in a similar situation a lot where it felt like he never got that opportunity, I guess. So if you follow him for a long time, I can see why you're frustrated that he didn't get a championship opportunity, because it seems like it always happens to him. But also, quick question: do you guys know how old he is? I actually had to look that up.
He's the same age as Damian Priest. I know that much.
How old did you say?
43.
A little off. It's 41.
I know he's the same age as Damian Priest, but Damian Priest is built as a like up and coming star,
which is crazy. Right?
Also, Damian Priest does look younger than 41. I think
he did. He did sometimes. A lot of work. He had a lot of work.
But sometimes when that eyeliner runs a little bit, and then.
There's the age. It's just, I don't know. I was gonna say something about it. Yeah, but
yeah, dummy.
I just anyone with catchphrases, I will immediately fall for it. It is just too good. I mean, when I went to the SmackDown in Memphis, I think the pops in order were Rock, Cody, neck and neck. Honestly, because Cody came out dark. LA Knight had a bigger pop than Randy.
That's
when he
wild.
Came out, they went insane, and it's so good. The moment we've all been waiting for, kind of the capping off of a year and a half rivalry. Oh, before I build it up, what I was going to say, Roman's only, or LA Knight's only title match opportunity on the main roster was against Roman, and everyone knew he was going to lose. But I feel like you could have had him win a U.S. title months ago, whenever his heat started, but
he did fight for the title, for the U.S. title, didn't he?
He's in the gauntlet match. I don't think he fought in the title match. I don't think so. Well, he could have had it this entire time instead of Logan. Whatever. No, he wore Logan. I think Logan is a fantastic worker, and I don't hate him as much for not being around because he's not a wrestler first. Whatever. Main event, night two, culmination of years, really. Cody and Roman in a stipulation still to be determined match for the WWE Universal Championship. Brennan, you get to kick us off. Go ahead and book us our biggest main event of all time.
First off, just like the day before, it's going to be a lot of emotions. Everyone's going to be wondering what's going to happen. I don't know if this is just me or anyone else. Until there's a winner, I'm going to be like, what if Roman wins? And when you say that, so I'm saying right now, I want Cody to win. I'm pretty sure he's got to win. He has to win. Not even for the story anymore, just for everything. Let it happen. I'm really, I can see where everyone's going to like chime in. The Bloodline's going to try to mess him up. And I think we were kind of talking about this at the very beginning of the podcast. I feel like we're going to see some returns. We're going to see some people, because we had the whole thing talked about. What was it? Whenever Rock was messing with Cody, you saw like the people in the background with the bus. You know what I'm talking about? So I'm guessing I got three people I think we're going to see. I don't know if anyone, like, this is crazy. We're going to see Hogan, Cena, and Stone Cold.
Hogan. Okay. I like
Yeah.
it.
I
I like
didn't
that.
know about the Hogan thing, but
Because
I
we
like
got,
it.
I just feel like we got the Bloodline, we got the Final Boss, we got everyone that's thinking they're the top dogs. People that have, I guess Roman has beaten as a champion. So I don't know. We'll see some stuff. I'm ready for like I'm gonna call it like now, maybe 3 or 4 times we're gonna think that Cody's losing. And then we'll just he'll kick out and he'll zoom in on Roman and just see the and he's like the 3rd or 4th time you're gonna be like, yeah, he knows he's gonna lose this. And that's what I'm ready for the emotions. So Cody wins, everyone's happy, the story's finished, and then we keep going. That's what I got.
To you on the biggest main event of all time.
So I like the Hogan. I've been actually thinking this about this all day because I knew we were doing the podcast tonight. Say Jay gets taken out the night before. Say Sammy gets taken out the night before. Say Kevin takes the pin earlier today, so he's banged up pretty bad. Let's say Seth is really messed up after his match. So in the ring, there would be Roman, who's,
Champion.
the champion. He'll obviously be there. You got Solo, Rock, Jimmy. Solo beat John Cena, so it makes sense for John Cena to show up to take him out. The Rock and Stone Cold is a tale as old as time. All right. That's okay. Okay. Who's taking out Jimmy? Hogan? Is there someone that we're forgetting that if they showed up to attack Jimmy, it would make so much sense? I'm asking. I literally have been thinking about it all day. I have no idea.
You set
I
that up
have
so
no
good.
idea.
Like both of us were like, oh, he's got this.
I was
I'm
on
ready
the edge of
for it.
my
I don't
seat.
know.
That
He's
was
got
so
this.
good.
No,
That
dude, I've been racking my
was
brain all day.
hard
No one. There's no one. Hogan's
to.
great. I like
Oh, so
that.
good. Also, the moment when you said the tale as old as time, also, this is all staying in. This is good. I'm thinking right now, what if we get Rock Austin one more time? What if
Dude,
we
don't mess with me. Don't play with my
Austin
emotions like
was
that.
so good 2 years ago, KO. He
Wait, he
was.
was with KO though. That helps.
He took a suplex on the concrete.
Yeah, and Kevin Owens to help him.
I think The Rock is in good enough shape. I think Austin is in good enough shape. I could see Rock and Austin
I don't know why I'm
one
arguing with you. I would also love to see that. You know
more.
what?
Duh,
You're
who
right.
wouldn't? Who wouldn't? Continue, continue. You only got to like the stare down so far.
Yeah, sorry, sorry. I'm so sorry. He said Hogan, and it just made me like, I've been racking my brain all day. I'm like, who would take out Jimmy? It would make sense. I don't want it to be Jay because Jay just had his match with him. Like, I want it just to be someone else, just somebody else. And all I could think all day, I was just like, who would it be? I thought Hogan because, the three, right, coming out. But everyone, Big E, maybe. Because didn't Big E lose to Roman, right?
He
Or
lost his
no?
title
He
to.
lost to Brock. He lost to Brock.
Whoa, that's twice. Two.
The guy who shouldn't be
Get
named.
one more and you're out.
I know. I keep saying the name.
You know that guy's beaten like almost every single African American champion in company history?
Oh, God. We don't need to talk about
As a
this anymore.
sidebar. Check out
Cut. Cut.
the
No, but like I thought maybe Big E, maybe New Day. I don't know. It'd probably be just Jay. It'd probably just be Jay. Okay. It's gonna be Jay and we're gonna be okay with it. All right. But love the entrance. But if anyone comes to help, I don't want it to be an ending where Roman loses because there was people to help. I want the help to come, run off all the bad guys. I also want the bad guys to be ran off, The Rock be left, and then Stone Cold comes down. I don't want them to come as a group. I want that to be like a, like Rock isn't scared of anyone. Glass breaks. Oh, I'm out. I gotta
That pop is gonna be
get.
generational if Austin comes out.
But I want after they get ran off, for both of them to stand up, wrestle, and Cody to win in the center of the ring. One, two, three. No, I mean, there's a little bull crap, but not really. Like, I don't want any of those guys to touch Roman. I don't want any of them to touch Roman. I don't want to be distracted. I want Cody to beat Roman. And as long as that happens, I'm cool with anyone showing up. Otherwise, like, if the options is for them to distract them or no one show up, I'd rather no one show up.
And that would be a true underdog of Cody really somehow defeating all of the odds.
Which would be good. Which would be so good. So
I just thought of someone that could return instead of Hogan to make it very short and sweet. I think he responded to something that The Rock said one time. And if you don't know what I'm saying by now, I'll hint and say, Cody has a brother.
Yeah, that's where I'm going.
Oh,
what I'm saying. So this, I would say I'm probably more invested in wrestling in the last year or so than since at any time other than when I was a little kid. I'd probably say in the last 5 or 6 years, I started caring about wrestling after like hiatus. The last year, I've been the most into wrestling I've been. I thought Cody should have won last year. Me and Andy had an argument. This is probably like, I think, over the summer or maybe going into last fall, to where I said, I think Cody has to obviously win the second time, but he doesn't have as much juice. He doesn't have as much heat. He's not as over. And he said, no, he's still over. He's still just as over. I didn't believe it. I still didn't believe it. Even winning the Rumble and pinpointing at Roman, I didn't really believe it. Rock comes back. I immediately am with the We Want Cody crowd. You cannot have this guy come back because we know he's going to lose. He's not going to be rolling for the title. No point at all. And the story we have gotten now with heel Rock has been so good. It has gotten Cody so much more over than he ever was before. It is turning into a two-night main event with two guys are main eventing WrestleMania both nights. That's crazy. And it's because of this Rock storyline. So it's fantastic. I also think that I think Triple H is a genius. I think he could have been just playing with our hearts and minds with Cena and Austin. I think they might not be there at all. They could be, I don't know. I think Triple H is deceiving enough to do that just to make people want and hope. I think Cena comes out. I don't know about Austin. I think Cena comes out. Maybe he takes out Solo or gets him out of the way. I'm surprised. I thought Brennan was going to bring up MJF. I think it's a work. I think he's still with AEW. I think it's a work to bring him back after injury to go after Adam Cole. That's basically the amount I know about AEW. Do not follow them. Do not care. But I think it's a work. I don't think MJF's in WWE. If he comes out, though, bananas. That place will explode.
If he comes out, AEW has to stop. You know what I mean? Like, they've lost.
Yeah. And it would be – I don't know. I don't know why. I just do have a dislike for AEW for some reason. It's because I'm a WWE mark as a child. But
I mean, they're just all – it's just the WWE roster now. That's basically what it is.
I feel this could be totally wrong assessment of who Tony Khan is, but I feel like he would have tried to leak it if MJF was actually signing with WWE. I could be wrong. But also, he could also be ingrained enough in wrestling culture to not spoil that. I don't know.
He didn't spoil Cody, though it was kind of
– kind of
new. But, I mean, he didn't do anything to spoil that. So
I think as far as MJF goes, he's either if he's here, which I would love it. I know. But he'll either debut the very beginning of WrestleMania or he'll come in on Raw. That's my call.
That would be a great Raw after Mania pop.
Just sells the show. That seals the deal.
I have been wanting for months Dustin Rhodes to come back. I've been wanting him to be a part of the storyline for months. And I don't think he's going to be there. I always loved the Goldust character. And as Dustin Rhodes, I mean, that first match Dustin and Cody had in AEW was so freaking good.
It was even before AEW. That was the right. That was like on the.
What was that All In? It was the first All In.
Yeah.
That, but it was the All In that started AEW, and Dustin bled like a pig. It was crazy.
It was wild. It was so.
But it was so good.
Partner.
So such a good story. I want Dustin to be there. I mean, he's an Attitude Era guy. He went toe to toe with The Rock when The Rock started in WWF.
Oh my God, that'd be so good if he came back. I
It
forgot
was
about
so good, and I don't think he'd come back as Gold Dust. I think he'd come back as Dustin Rhodes, and it
I
would be
think
so good. Maybe he has a
no.
little gold face paint on. Maybe it's half his face, like the Dustin Rhodes character.
Or
I
you
think he'll
like
at
see
least be in
him
the
come
crowd.
out. It's like the Gold Dust theme comes out, and he comes out, but he's got a mask on, and then he just takes the mask off, and he's got whatever theme he wants, and he's Dustin Rhodes. I think he'll get the same amount of pop, regardless if he's Gold Dust or Dustin Rhodes.
Oh yeah.
He might have any makeup on, and he would get a pop.
Oh yeah.
Okay.
Maybe he comes out. Well, it also depends on the match. Like, there's sometimes music hits, and they have to be running down for what's happening, or he can take his time. If it's one of the ones where he takes his time, Gold Dust music hits. Got Gold Dust robe on, big old hood, takes it off, no gold dust, rips it off, whatever badass theme, he runs down to the ring.
I'm
But
assuming if he shows up, he needs to be in a hurry, though.
yeah, good
Yeah.
chance.
Cody's
Unless,
getting the
because I
crowd going with
think,
him.
well, also, this could be great. If you could bet on this, the how long will Roman's entrances be on the night?
Oh, God.
I think we're in for 10-minute entrances.
Dude, Rock and
It's gonna be
Roman
some
back to
Undertaker
back
level.
as tag teams,
Here's
followed
the
by
thing.
Cody and Seth. It's gonna be 40 minutes before that match.
Yeah, which is why it's 6 hours long. I don't like this as much, but this just adds to the cinema of it. Because it's not as often they have the it's very rare actually for the champ to come out first and then the challenger. It happens every once in a while. They did Sammy actually. Sammy came out second because they were in Canada. What if Roman comes out with Solo and Jimmy and Rock in tow? Four of them standing in the ring. Cody's music hits, and then Dustin's music hits, and then
Oof.
Cena's music hits, and then
Oh,
Austin's music hits. And
playing
then
my emotions right
they
now.
just march to the ring, and it's Bloodline rules. So I assume as soon as a punch is thrown, the bell rings, and the ref's out of it after that. Also, I think there could be 17 different refs. I think there'll be a lot of ref bumps.
Can be
But that would
unconscious
just
in
be,
the
do you know how loud, like you're, if you have a bad TV, the speaker might break of how loud that crowd would be if you had Austin, Cena, Dustin, and Cody walking down to
They're
meet
gonna be
them
so
four in the
tired.
ring.
They're gonna be so tired, like exhausted. I went to a WrestleMania a few years ago. Behind the main event, it was Roman and someone I can't say the name a third time or I get kicked from this call. And everyone just felt exhausted at that point. You're just kind of just like, oh
I remember
my
watching
God, and screaming for hours.
the Mania when Kofi beat Daniel Bryan for the title.
That was the 11-hour one
The
on
crowd was
Mania.
so hot for that match, and then for two, I don't remember what they were. There were two matches after that where the crowd just did nothing, because it really, like, the crowd does get fatigued and it will affect it. And that's why I think, I don't know what match it would be on night two. I
I
feel
bet not
you've got
either.
to put one of the matches that you know the crowd doesn't have to be as invested in. Maybe it's the street fight. I honestly it might have to be the street fight.
I think it's LA Knight
Or
versus.
you just have a big, maybe you have Jason Kelsey do his promo.
Oh, yeah.
You have,
Oh, yeah.
you gotta, I think you'll have to give the time because that, yeah, it's the end of a 6 hour, and most people that are there for one day are there for both, I do assume.
Well, it's I only went to one because it was a little expensive.
Expensive, but I do assume a lot of people go to both.
Well, think about this: the people who are there for Friday night SmackDown, then they're
Yeah,
there for the Hall of Fame afterwards. Then they go to the NXT thing
XD.
in the morning. Then they go to the show on Saturday night. Then they go to Sunday night. By that main event, that person is going, "Oh my God, I'm going to the Raw after Mania after this too. I'm gonna die." Like they are so tired, but it doesn't matter. They're gonna be loud. Like, I'm just saying, they're going to be exhausted when they get home. It's going to feel like they ran a marathon. All they did was sit there and watch
and yell. But yeah. And then we got to the finish. Unfortunately, I don't think Tony Khan will give up anyone to go to the WWE's biggest show to be a part of their biggest storyline. No matter how good of a sweet talker Triple H is, I don't see it happening. I don't think MJF's there. And then Austin, Cena, obviously, I mean, those are just, I mean, two of the biggest stars of all time. But it makes a little, I mean, it makes sense. But it doesn't make sense in Cody's story. Dustin makes sense in Cody's story. Austin and Cena don't. I also, maybe Seth and Jay do come hobbled and try and do something. I'm pretty sure there's one other Samoan family member in WWE's like performance center.
Yeah, Tomaloa or whatever his name is from Bullet Club.
Yeah,
Tamatonga.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. And then you got Ava, the Rock's daughter, and
she ain't gonna. She's the. I don't know why they made her the GM of NXT the same week they brought back Will Regal, but whatever.
Wild. It's wild.
I think there's one other.
Tamina is a part of the bloodline, technically.
Oh, yeah.
Naomi is a part of the bloodline, technically.
Yeah.
I was actually shocked that she's not with you.
I think it'll be a fantastic match. Bloodline rules. There's going to be hijinks. There's going to be people coming out and fighting that aren't a part of the match. There's going to be some weapons. There might be a barbed wire wrapped something or another. I think there will be blood spilled by somebody.
Mama Rhodes.
Mama Rhodes, look what you've done. I do think I can see Roman and Cody both bleeding. The amount of blood that they let Cody have on Raw, the fact that it's WrestleMania on Peacock, I would love to see them both bleed a little. Ultimately, as I'm talking about it, I want Cody to win very badly. I'm very deep in story and kayfabe in this story in particular. I want Cody to win. I need Cody to win for my wrestling sanity. It's something that pissed me off today I read. It's a guy who I think is a buffoon and is part of the downfall of WCW, Vince Russo, the head writer. I read, and he's an idiot. Everything he says I think is bull, and I love whenever Jim Cornette goes off on him. But he said something, and it was something along the lines of, what if the WWE is still in it for the WWE? What if Cody Rhodes is still the guy who went to AEW, and at AEW, he took the sledgehammer and smashed the throne, the King of Kings throne, and what if the WWE still says, this is the WWE, and Roman Reigns wins? I don't know how it plays out. I can't have Roman Reigns win, but I'm just like you said, Brennan. I am not convinced that Cody wins until he does.
Yeah, no, I'm still gonna be tense the whole time of the match.
He has to win. I think he wins. I am not sure of it whatsoever because anything is possible. And what I thought a few weeks ago,
also Hogan's ring.
Yeah, well. Yeah, exactly. What if Triple H really wants one of his guys to be the longest title holder?
Oh, he's not going to get close to that.
No one cares about Bruno. Everyone sees
Hogan. We don't talk about Bruno.
Everyone sees Hogan's reign. If Roman beats Hogan's reign, it cements it, I think, as the greatest of all time, if you don't already think so. Cody has to win. He has to finish the story.
Buddy. Cody, I pray for you. I will call you to check on you if Cody is.
Oh, Brennan left. Brennan's gone. His phone died. That was again anyway. The only thing I was gonna say was that kind of bounced off you a little. What if Roman
continue without Brennan?
Yeah, I mean his phone died. I have one little splurge left and I'm done. Okay. I was thinking Rock takes up too much of the ring, too much of the applause. He gets to it with Roman. That's kind of a thing the whole match. At some point in time, Roman slaps him or pushes him and says, hey, I'm head of the table. Rock bottom. Rock leaves. Not Cody pins him right away, but that sets up Cody for the win. But I still, I'm fine with that. But I think there still need to be a lot of match after that happening.
I want Cody to win. I don't want Cody to be handed to win.
Well, I don't think on if The Rock hits Roman with the rock bottom, that doesn't mean him being handed to win. But
no, but if he pins him,
have a match. Oh, yeah. And I don't think Triple H would do that. He returned. He's trying to return. He's attempting.
That was awkward.
His phone died.
The outro.
Dead phone.
I'm like this now. This is what we're doing.
that was literally the end of it. We have 7 minutes left on Zoom. We can run through this real quick. Just recapping what we think happens. I think Rhea beats Becky. Was that unanimous?
Yeah.
Okay. Yep. I think Gunther beats Sammy.
Mm-hmm. I want Sammy, but it might not.
The first thing I think we said was that this WrestleMania, there's a winner we think, but any match could go any way. I think we all agree with it, but I think we agreed on a lot of the picks. Six-pack ladder match. I got the Golden Truth and DIY. Andy had some nonsense, but R-Truth definitely getting at least part of the title.
Yes, R-Truth wins. That's all that matters.
R-Truth wins every title.
Loses it to the next night, by the way. Yeah. That's part of my prediction. No matter who R-Truth wins with, he loses Monday.
Yeah. And I think you're both rooting for New Catch Republic.
British.
What a name.
We got Damage Control losing a tag match.
Yep. Okay, yes. If anyone disagrees, Bianca's also going to stay undefeated at WrestleMania. New Undertaker, by the way, just going to throw that up there. Continue.
Ooh, I like that call.
Yeah, I will be all behind Bianca when she loses her hair gimmick. But
that's when she turns heel.
I got, which would be great. And she doesn't have to chop off all her hair. She just needs to cut it a little, just so it's like that long.
I love it.
It's just stupid. It's dumb. Oh, I'm going to hit you with my braid. Why is that the gimmick? Whatever. Doesn't matter.
He's Jimmy, very strong about this.
Jimmy and Jay. Yeah, that's a really dumb thing to care about, too. Jimmy and Jay. Me and Andy have Jimmy. Brennan has main event Jay Uso. Love to see Jay win. And I think we all agree that we kind of would have liked the story to be told a little better.
If that match was on night two, I would 100% think it's Jay. But because it's on night one, I think it's Jimmy.
That's true.
Ray and Dragon Lee, Santos and Dom. I picked Santos and Dom. Did either of you guys go?
I think we all picked that.
Yeah, that'll be a banger.
Means Ray's going to win.
Rock and Roman, Cody and Seth. We got Rock and Roman, night one. Drew and Seth, night two. In some sort of fashion, we all believe Drew wins.
Yeah.
Good chance. Punk messes around in the match. Damian Priest might be featured. We all think Logan Paul wins. If any of them won, it'd be great, honestly. I mean, it helps Logan Paul continue his start, gets KO a title again if he has it. Randy gets a title at the back half of his career. Good for him.
Yeah.
Lashley in the Street Profits versus Final Testament. I got Final Testament winning. I think one of you guys had Bobby Lashley winning.
I think you picked Bobby Lashley.
Did I?
Yeah.
Oh, I did. Yeah. I said that. It's been a long time since I said that. It was two Zooms ago. I think Triple H is ready to scrap AOP and Karrion, even though he loves Karrion Kross and Profits and Bobby Wynn.
Let's bring Karrion back to NXT. We're fine.
Yeah. Have him replace, send him down, bring Baron Corbin up. It'll be perfect.
Yep. Yep.
EO and Bailey, we all have Bailey. Andy likes the story a little less than we do.
Oh, actually, I like the story. I think they didn't do a good job with it.
Yeah. Yeah, and AJ Styles. I got it. Did you both pick AJ Styles, or one of you picked AJ Styles?
I picked AJ. AJ
Styles. I picked LA Knight. Yeah. Oh, man.
Then Roman and Cody, just, I mean, truly setting up for the most hyped up match in recent memory.
I'm so nervous, man. I'm so nervous.
For Cody's winning. Come on.
Yeah, I think so.
We don't know, though.
There's no way he loses. There's no way he loses.
But there's a chance. What
if he does?
Roman's never losing, dude.
I think
he'll win and then just retire.
I think if Roman won, I would probably take a little break from watching wrestling.
Well, I feel like, you know, you got that post-WrestleMania lull anyway every year.
No, so. But I would be excited to see where Cody – I am excited to see where Cody goes with it afterwards.
Do you think he'll hold it for a long time, or do you think he'll actually lose it pretty quickly because
– He'll hold it for over a year.
He's got to. I feel like he has.
I think he goes against Rock or Roman WrestleMania next year. Because if Roman wins – he's got it for another year. He's not losing it at anything other than WrestleMania. So we get another year of no Roman on TV, no championship on TV. Who's another guy we're going to feed to the wolves? It can't be Roman. It shouldn't be Roman. It won't be Roman, but I don't believe that until it happens.
Yep.
And that's it. That's episode 15, the Cody Porter Sports Show. We'll see you next time.
Bye.
Yeah.